In this video, I like to show you how to convert a context-free grammar into an equivalent grammar, so a grammar that accepts or generates the same language, in Greibach normal form. First, let me tell you what Greibach normal form is. That means every production rule looks like this. Let me give you some examples. We can have a non-terminal expands to a terminal, or we can have a non-terminal expands to a terminal followed by another non-terminal, or we can have something like a non-terminal expands to terminal followed by a very long list of non-terminals. So every production rule must look like this, that there's one, that the first symbol on the right-hand side is a terminal, and then there can be an arbitrary long concatenation of non-terminals. And if you have a grammar like this, it's in Greibach normal form. I heard there's something like called deterministic Greibach normal form, which allows several terminals before any list of non-terminals, but that's not in the scope of this video. So let's have a look at this grammar, or let me first remove those notes we don't need anymore. So let's have a look at this grammar. Here we have a rule which starts with a terminal but has a terminal in the middle that's not allowed. Here we have rules that are okay, that have just one terminal on the right-hand side. These rules are not okay. This one is fine, and these two we also have to change. So let's start with the first one. Here you see we have a terminal C right in the middle, and I could either introduce a new non-terminal and then create a rule like this. So like for example, X expands to a terminal C. But in this case, because C, this is the only rule for the non-terminal C, we can just reuse this one. So I will replace those terminal C in the right-hand side by those non-terminal C. And because those non-terminal C derives to the terminal C, it is equivalent to what we have before. So I will just replace this part. Let me just take this rule away, and I will replace it by a new rule where S derives to A, B, now those big non-terminal C and another B. So then this rule is in Greibach normal form. Let's have a look at those B. We have a non-terminal A on the right-hand side as first symbol on this rule, and you see those A derives to two different terminals. So let me show you how this looks like. If you have in a derivation, B derives to AC, and then this A derives to either this terminal A or to the terminal B, you will end up in the A case either with this one or in the other case with B followed by the C. So if you apply the first rule, you will replace this non-terminal A by this terminal A, or if you apply the other rule, you will get those terminal B. So we can just create a rule in Greibach normal form. If we just skip this part and directly allow B to derive to one of these. So I will remove this rule and say B can now derive to either AC or BC. So because we replace this A, and that's the that are the two possibilities. Then look, let's look at the other rule. There we have a non-terminal D, but as you can see here, D has two rules where they are non-terminals. The first symbols on the right-hand side, so replacing the D by these two brings us nothing. So I will just save this one up for later and have a look at this one, at these rules first. So let's have a look at those. D expands to as C. Here we have two problems. One is that we have the C or the terminal C on the second place. So in one step, it's not the final step, but in one step, similar to what I did for the S, I will replace those C by this non-terminal C, and for that add a new rule, D expands to S. C. So now I have removed the terminal C that's not on the first position. And then the other problem is that we have those non-terminal S on the first place. But luckily we already have this rule. And if we would just do the derivation where we replace those S by all this part, we will just get a new rule in Greibach normal form. So I will now replace those S by all this stuff. This is the only rule, so I just need to replace those S by this one stuff. And I will add the new rule with D expands to A, B, C, B, and we keep those C we had here from before. So now we have this rule in Greibach normal form. Then we have those AB rule. This is what we can quickly do as we did for the B. So I will just replace those A by the two possibilities, so by either A or B. So away it goes. And we get two new rules. D expands to AB or D expands to B. B. And then we have all those D rules in Greibach normal form. Now the only rule we need to take care of left is those B rule. And now we can just proceed as we did before. We replace those D by every right hand side rule of those of D rules. So by these three. So I will replace this D and remove for that this rule, and then we add this part A B C B C, and I need to keep the C we had there before. Then this part, this rule A B followed by those C, and now BB also followed by the C. And now when you look through all the rules, we have a new new production rules in Greibach normal form. Now if you want to do it formally correctly, you would have to write down the new definition. So you could write down, we have a new grammar G1 which has the non-terminals, and then I list all of them up, so it's S, A, B, C, C, D, and then I would list up all the terminals, A, B, C, and if I would had needed to add a new rule, like those C expands to C, I would of course need to mention the new non-terminal symbol in the new definition. Then I will have my new production rules, which I can could call P1, and my start symbol is the same. And yeah, those P1 will be all this stuff. I will not I will not write them down all over again. So these new colorful rules are now my new set of production rules, P1. And also another point, if you have a really close look, you see that we have that D doesn't appear in any right-hand side rule anymore, so D is a useless symbol, but this doesn't violate Greibach normal form, so I will, in this example, I don't care for that. And I still have my grammar now in Greibach normal form.